Hello students, we are studying the lesson A Triumph of Surgery. In our previous session, we came to know that Mr. Harriet suggested Mrs. Pumphrey to reduce Tricky's food and give him more exercise. But it did not work. Within few days, he got a call from Mrs. Pumphrey. When he went to her house, he found that Tricky was seriously ill and he did not want to eat anything or to do anything. Now let us continue the lesson. I had made my plans in advance. The only way was to get Tricky out of the house for a period. I suggested that he be hospitalized for about a fortnight to be kept under observation. The narrator had already made his plan about how to treat Tricky. He knew that the only way to get Tricky well was to get him out of the house, Mrs. Pumphrey's house, for a few days. He suggested to Mrs. Pumphrey that Tricky must be hospitalized and he must be kept under observation of veterinary doctor or nurses for about a fortnight. Fortnight means a period of 14 nights or 2 weeks. Here we can understand that Mr. Harriet knew very well that because of excessive care and food, Tricky had become ill. So he wanted to separate Tricky from home to avoid the special care and food. The poor lady almost swooned. She was sure he would pine and die if he did not see her every day. Hearing the words of the narrator, the poor lady swooned. Here, poor lady is Mrs. Pumphrey. And the word poor not used in the sense of possession of money here. It is used to express pity. She was swooned. Swooned means fainted or lost consciousness. It means hearing the words of narrator, she was so much shocked that she was about to lose her consciousness. She was sure he would pine and die if he did not see her every day. She was sure Tricky would pine and die. Here pine means miss or long for. She is thinking he would die if Tricky did not see her every day. Because he would miss her lot. This shows us the great attachment and intimacy between Tricky and Mrs. Pumphrey. But I took a firm line. Tricky was very ill and this was the only way to save him. In fact, I thought it best to take him without delay and followed by Mrs. Pumphrey's wailing. I marched out to the car carrying little dog wrapped in a blanket. I took a firm line. Here the narrator, Mr. Harriet, he took firm line. Firm line means firm decision or he is determined. He did not have other choice because Tricky was very ill and separating him from the house was the only way for him to save Tricky. And he did not want to make delay. He decided to take Tricky to hospital as soon as possible. He moved towards his car carrying little dog wrapped in a blanket. Here wrapped mean covered in a blanket. And Mrs. Pumphrey was also following him and she was wailing. Wailing means crying. The entire staff was roused and maids rushed in and out, bringing his day bed, his night bed, favorite cushions, toys, the rubber rings, breakfast ball, lunch ball, supper ball. Realizing that my car would never hold all this stuff, I started to drive away. As I moved off, Mrs. Pumphrey, with a despairing cry, threw an armful of a little coats through the window. I looked in the mirror before I turned the corner of the drive. Everybody was in tears. The entire staff was aroused. Here staff means the servants and maids of Mrs. Pumphrey. And roused means to awake or to be woken, to be awakened from the sleep. It means they became very active and they started to bring all the stuff. Stuff means things which were belong to Tricky. What are those stuff? His day bed, his night bed, favorite cushions, toys, the rubber rings, breakfast balls, lunch ball, supper ball. They started to bring all these things. But the narrator realized that his car would never hold all this stuff. So he started to drive away the car. While the narrator was leaving with Tricky, Mrs. Pumphrey, with despairing cry means helpless cry, threw some little coats of Tricky inside the car, through the car window. And while narrator was turning his car, on the turn, he saw through the mirror that everyone was crying. They were expressing their sadness because they have to stay away from Tricky for 14 days. Out on the road, I glanced down at the pathetic little animal gasping on the seat by my side. I patted the head and Tricky made a brave effort to wag his tail. Poor old lad, I said. You haven't a kick in you, but I think I know a cure for you. While his car was moving on the road, the narrator looked at the pathetic little animal. Which is the pathetic little animal here? Tricky. Pathetic mean pitiful or arousing sympathy. And Tricky was gasping. Gasping mean struggling to take breathe. He was on the seat by the side of narrator. Narrator patted on the head of Tricky and Tricky responded him by wagging his tail with difficulty. Wag means to swing from side to side, especially of an animal's tail. Narrator expressed his pity for the dog and he told he knew that Tricky did not have any kick. Kick means energy. But he knew how to cure Tricky. It means the narrator had his own plan to cure Tricky. Then what was his plan to cure Tricky? We shall see in tomorrow's session.